Today, we're going to walk through how to create an RV record and then submit an EFW2 file via TAP. The first thing we need to do is access TAP. We can do that at www.tax.idaho.gov and then click on the TAP icon in the lower center portion of the screen. You need to log in with your username and password and then verify your credentials by generating a code that will be sent to your text or your email. Once you're in your TAP account, I want you to find More up in the headers and go ahead and click on that. In the next screen, you'll see Payments and Returns on the left side, and then click on Upload an EFW2 file. In the new window, you'll see over to the right, there's a Create an RV Record. Go ahead and click on that. In the new window, go ahead and enter in the amounts generated from your software or from another source like an accountant or something like that. And then select Generate RV Record. At this point, you're going to copy and paste that RV record into your EFW2 file using the directions that are on screen. Make sure that you place it after the RT record. And then make sure that you copy the entire record. It should be 512 characters. The easiest way to do that is to triple-click on that RV record, and then right-click and copy. Once you've done this, go ahead and save the EFW2 file. And then we're going to go back to TAP, and we're going to select Choose File. In the Type field, select the year that you're filing for. In our example, it's 2023. In the description field, go ahead and type in a short description, for instance, a 2023 EFW2 file. Once you have the information in there, go ahead and select the Choose File button. Now we're going to find that EFW2 file with the RV record that you just created. Go ahead and find it, browse to it, and then select it. If the correct file appears, go ahead and select the OK button. Now on this screen, you'll see where it says that the file has been validated, but it has not been submitted yet. You will need to click on the Submit button to actually submit the EFW2 file. If you get errors on your EFW2 file, you'll need to fix the errors and then choose that file again with the corrections and then submit it.